These awards are the biggest business events in Bath, Bristol, Cardiff, and Exeter. And today we'll be talking about how you can benefit from them, and indeed how you might win. But first, take a look at this. It's just joyous. I would be nothing without you holding me up. Not strong enough for all the world. Happy memories. We celebrate the whole of the city, all sectors, all types, from commercial to charity and civic, from new companies to long-established ones, and from the smallest of the indies to the largest of the corporates, everyone coming together to celebrate.
So on to the commercial opportunities. These awards have built over the years into a central feature of business and civic life in each of the cities. We're focused on promoting events which create value. From thousands of companies, hundreds of nominations, and dozens of sponsors, distinct value opportunities are created. We'll be going through the benefits of the awards, the range of businesses involved, and some of their reasons, with commercial options crafted for a variety of business sizes and budgets.
Yeah, the heart of the awards is that celebration of the cities, from the smallest of the indies to the largest of the corporates, all coming together. We're keen to reward and highlight and celebrate business achievement and civic authenticity. The awards recognise excellence, the best businesses and organisations in the year. Could that be you? Who knows? You have to nominate. It's one of the most powerful positionings to align your brand with success in the context of high-profile celebration. And as Steph says, there are multiple ways to engage the awards commercially to fit all forms of business need, strategies, and budgets. Think of it this way. The promoting VARAS is not just effective, but it's highly efficient. A single deal unlocks this value. Think of the effort it would otherwise take to generate this activity. One deal, all that reach with key customers, all those opportunities of connecting, all that time spent with them. Time together, we've been increasingly thinking, is in some ways the most underrated of business KPIs. Perhaps that's in part to do with what's been happening the last couple of years. Time together in one room, in one place, conversations, that's where business happens. And imagine having the most prominent, the largest business event in each city where business is done. This form of social business is highly, highly effective way to generate new contacts, build new relationships, and create opportunities. Imagine also the benefits of being backed by an extensive, effective, powerful marketing campaign. There's a deeper point here as well. Consider the mindset of everyone involved in the awards. It's highly positive. That's a great backdrop to build business. Placing your brands, your people in such a positive, joyous environment can have limitless benefits.
So let's come on to some of the options. Firstly, we have our gold level category sponsorship. This is the gold star offering, one of the highest levels of engagement with hundreds of companies and with the awards. Deep association at all levels, from the marketing to the kinship with the credibility and values of the awards. The opportunity to choose the category that best fits strategically with your aims, maybe a particular one directly aligned with your business development. That might be a category such as legal, financial, business services, education, restaurant, whatever works for your business, or an area you wish to be associated with for brand benefits such as charity, arts and creative, civic or sustainability. And you'll have a standout role on awards night, as well as having a prominently positioned table for your guests and the team. We seek to work closely with our gold sponsors in particular, so talk to us about the best ways to engage and generate value. And we'll have some testimonials shortly from a variety of sponsors. Next is the silver level sponsorship. This is a secondary category with a dress table and marketing before, during and after the awards. It's a great chance to share good times with your clients in a sophisticated, celebratory, feel-good environment. Plus marketing benefits, limited release early bird silvers are now available on the websites. Or for those watching in December on YouTube, they may have gone by now, but please talk with the teams. Next, we have our feature options, anything from sponsoring the shoulder events like the grand reveals and the finalist receptions, or the cover stars, our giant special covers at the awards with a sponsor's logo. Posing is irresistible and social activity is incredible on this one. Or try this for inventive thinking. Lexus have special customized versions of their cars at the Bristol and Cardiff Life Awards. One was the world's first tattooed car. The other was designed by a local artist. Both received massive coverage via the awards. And you can buy tickets to be there. Of course, there's the option just to join on the night, celebrate the city, build business contacts, join the exclusive pre-drinks and then the after-show party. And if you're a finalist, you may even be one of the winners as well. So who are our sponsors? A highly diverse group with different business needs to engage with the awards.
Actually, just before we come on to those, we've had a few more questions in from our good friend or friends called Anonymous, who are avid viewers of what we do, which is always good to know. If I'm thinking about sponsoring a category of the awards, can I also nominate my business? The answer is yes, with the caveat. Yes, of course, sponsors can nominate. They're treated entirely objectively, and we'll talk about the judging process subsequently. The caveat is please do not attempt to sponsor a category in which you're entering. If that's your expertise, please don't enter that if you wish to sponsor it. So yes, enter, but please don't sponsor a category you're going to be entering. This person or someone else perhaps also said, I noticed that one of your judges is a client of ours. Would this be classed as a conflict of interest? We'll come on to that in the judges section, but the basic point is this. Judges, if they've either have in reality or a perception of any form of conflict of interest, they are recused, which means they're exempted. They're not allowed to be part of the discussion of that category. So it is for the judges to decide if a fellow judge should be recused. Some cases it's obvious, some cases it's a discussion, but there isn't necessarily, if it's a one of our preceding judges, that isn't a conflict because of course it's a new group of judges each time. Let's come on to our sponsors. Some of them are nationals and you can see some really big names here and it's great to have their support. They want to engage deeply in their cities and to play their part. A terrific range from an international insurance company to a locally founded national cider company, luxury car brand, top end real estate to international property company. Others are regional or even city specific, seeking to connect deeply to gain business value, but also to stand out from immediate competitors in those cities. Others still have a particular offering that works really closely with awards, such as hospitality, venues, sports companies, multiple others. Here's a roll call of some of our current sponsors, and there are quite a few of them. Delighted to have their support. A few things to bear in mind in general about sponsorship. Sponsorships can be for 1, 2, or 3 years with sliding discounts. There are only a finite number of sponsorships, which of course aids the standout. There's value directly from the awards and marketing campaigns, but also the opportunity to create your own value by leveraging your relationship with the awards. Please do talk to us about your ideas, and thanks to all our sponsors indeed.
Yes, thank you. And here's what just a few of our sponsors say about why they support the awards and the benefits they gain. You can read here some of the comments and see that for some, it's about profile, others connection and partnerships. Some wish to have a specific association with a category, as we mentioned earlier. Others wish to benefit from the full spread of marketing in association with the city's leading business activities. And others still wanting to demonstrate their support for and connection with the city to be a proud Bath, Bristol, Cardiff or Exeter company. And that's especially true in these times where veneration of local companies is a profound trend for businesses and consumers. Again, thank you to all our sponsors. You can see some of their kind words here and how they've benefited. all the key dates that you need to make a note of if you plan on getting involved with the awards this year. So nominations are now open in Bath, Bristol and Cardiff, and will be next week in Exeter from the 29th of November. And nominations will close. So Cardiff is just a few days after we're back after Christmas, Tuesday, January 16th. So please don't miss that. Then Bristol on January 18th, Bath January 24th and Exeter on February the 2nd. We'll send out multiple warnings via all the channels, don't worry. And the period covered is 2022. So there really is no need to wait until the deadlines. You can capture everything from this year. We read through and discuss all the nominations and then shortlist only the best, as Greg said. Mm. We have several hundred entrants each year to the awards, so not all can make the shortlist, unfortunately. The finalists are those with the most credible chance of winning each category. And then we announce the finalists in one go, live on Zoom and on social media on the days you can see there, each at 2 p.m. And don't worry, all the dates are also on the awards websites. So to recap, Bath is the 1st of February, Bristol's the 25th of January, Cardiff's the 19th of January, and Exeter's the 8th of February. And do register for the grand reveals when you nominate and save the date to see if you're a finalist. We then hold the exclusive receptions for all our finalists and sponsors on these dates. Bath is February the 20th, Bristol's February the 13th, Cardiff's January 31st and Exeter's February 27th. Speaking of the receptions, they are just joyous occasions in themselves. A few weeks ahead of the awards with all of the finalists and sponsors, all in all around 150 people in each city. But they're also highly valuable, exclusive business networking events. And as we know, business starts with a conversation. And then there's the big nights, all of the awards. So save these dates. Bath is March the 23rd, Bristol's March the 16th, the Cardiff Life Awards will be on February 23rd, and Exeter Living Awards March the 30th. Four incredible Thursdays in 6 weeks, which we just can't wait for.
When many, many hundreds of businesses come together and are promoted extensively, value is created for all. Here are the Media Clash contacts with information, and of course, all information is on the award sites. And in closing, thank you for considering the awards. We hope that you'd find us to be dynamic partners, helping you generate business and also to celebrate your success. Good luck with your business in this coming year. This has been a Media Clash production.